So what will be here? Here I will tell you a little about what is Bayesian network, if you're not familiar with, although I suppose you're familiar, what is about text attribution, and present some experimental result. So what is Bayesian network? So Bayesian network was introduced by Judy Appel in 85, and idea is very simple. You can use the standard chain rule of theory probability, probability rule, chain rule, and then you can present it like a mutual dependency. For example, if you just follow this, you can say xn define x3 and everything which after that, x2 define, etc. So you just present this joint probability distribution like this graphical presentation. So in this case, you can present it if you go deeper for calculation. You will have the directed acyclic graph, which presents the dependency. And for every node, you can provide the local probability or conditional probability function. In the network, in the Bayesian network, you use for this table, because Bayesian network mostly working with discrete variables. Although there are ways how it works with continuous variables as well. So what is interesting here? So if you, in your case, have some independencies, for example, if I take this example, and I assume here that x2 is independent of x3 and x4, and I assume that x3 is like this, x1 dependent only x2 and 3, but 4 and not 3, and x2 is independent on everybody else. So then it will be presented in simpler graph, and I will have simple probability table for every node to encode the same joint probability distribution. So in very general way, every network could be presented like this. Yep. Okay. Sorry. Okay. So if you have some independency, your network becomes sparser and sparser. If everything is joint probability distribution, everything dependent from everything, in this case, you will have complete network, the worst case. Our assumption is that our data in reality are sparse, so not everything dependent for everything, but they divided on some models, and we want to find these models, and this is one of the goal of this exercise. So this is just two examples which I show here how it could be, look like. So, first of all, you have to understand that in this case, the direction of this graph is not really defined, okay, not fully defined. There are many equivalent graphs. For example, these two graphs are fully equivalent because you can start the rule chain from the X1, or you can start it from X4, and you have the same very valid equation. So it means these two presentations are equal. But it's not always the case. And there are examples when you could distinguish two cases. This is so-called V structure. For example, this structure is different from this one. And you can experimentally measure it. For example, in this structure, X2 and X3 are independent. But if you fix X1, they start to be dependent. So conditioning of X1, X2, and X3 dependent. In this case, opposite, X2 and X3 dependent, but conditioning of X1, they become independent. So these two structures have principal difference. And this is what we can possibly recognize in the Bayesian network if we can learn it from the data, and then using these things to better understand the data under study. So the Bayesian network learning algorithms was developed from the beginning of 90s, and this I present the first and most influential data works which introduced it here, and they introduce the two notion, first how to learn network, and what use like measure how network well fit or not fit to experimental data. So the most used and most interesting, I will say, approach, which is widely used, is so-called BDE metric. So what is this? This was done by Heckerman, Geiger, and Chickering in 94. So they calculate the probability data given structure of Bayesian network, regardless of the parameters which are probability table in every node. So this they do by marginalization over the all possible distribution of parameters. This is classical way, Bayesian way. And after they do this all calculation, they come to this formula. So I will not go to detail, but they come to this formula where this is prior for given structure. And this n prime is number of, let's say, imaginary Dirichlet, set generated by Dirichlet process from the complete Bayesian network with the same number of variables, the same number of states. So this is parameter which left after all the calculations they introduce. And this is like free parameter to tune. So in case if you say that uniform is the prior is uninformative, it comes from the prior in reality, then you can say that it's equally distributed between the all possible state. So if you have variable which have Ri possible state, and it has the number of parents in the graph, so the guys who it condition on, which have altogether Qi state, so then we say that n prime by R1 by Qi is probability of every of combination. So all of them equal, given the structure of network. So the, of course, this measure, it's not fully normalized, but you, because we don't know this term, we can say it's constant, for example, but of course it has some value, does not matter which value it is. So this value could be used like measure to compare different network structure given data. Because here we have probability data and Bayesian structure, but if we keep, we try to maximize only this part, we can find the most probable structure given data. So this is quite classical. Problem is that we can't enumerate all networks because this number increases over exponentially. So it means that practically we can calculate for 7 or maybe 8 node network and then we will stop because we just can't enumerate all of them. And therefore people start to use different greedy algorithms, which is classical way what we can do, or genetic algorithms or some another deterministic and non-deterministic algorithm, which is generally, I want to stress two of them. So this is K2 greedy, which was shown that in reality converge to the global optimum if your data set big enough, it was proven. But it requires that variables are ordered. It means, which means they are ordered. If you provide the order for variable, the variable have to be conditioned only on the variable which are higher in the order. So the topest one is not conditioned to anything. The second one could be conditioned on the top one, on the first one. The fifth could be conditioned or not conditioned only on those which above it but not below. If you have this order on the variables, you can build algorithm which theoretically in your data set is big enough, converge to global optimum. This was proven. But of course, this order in many cases is unknown. Of course, if you know precisely the organization of data, maybe you know this from causal dependencies, etc. But in practical way, we don't know this. So there are constraint-based algorithms. Oops, sorry. When you try to find this structure like V, which I showed before first, and then constrain your network search. But generally, in reality, they produce not so good result. Okay, so now I switch to the second part, text attribution, which is toy example. So text attribution is old story when people try to find who is author of the text. So this mostly attributed to the history, when they, who is author of the Shakespeare poems, or even Russian, you will say, is Sholokhov author of the Quiet Flow of the Don, And other examples from the history when they try to find out who is author of the specific text, given you have set of candidates you want to attribute. So this is old story of these things, And mostly people use the criteria which is qualitative. So they say, well, I read this paper, this book or this text, and this written like this author, the same style, the same flavor. This is very personal, expert-dependent, in reality quite easily to be falsified if a person who writes the text talented enough to pretend it's somebody else. It's not so complicated, and many people, especially young writer, write in the style of. Then you can put off whatever you want. So in the 1915, Morozov offers a called linguistic spectra. So he select three functional words in Russian, vi, v, in, on, and with, and calculate its number per 1,000 words of the text. And he claimed this is unique for given author. He tried to prove it doing the manual calculation for Gogol, Pushkin, and Tolstoy, and draw this so-called linguistic spectra, and say they are quite different to discriminate these three authors. This work was interested, the famous Markov was very interested of this work, and expand calculation for more authors and more text, and show that the power of this method very limited. So if he start to calculate not three authors, but five, seven, it's immediately found that there are too many collisions when it's not impossible to resolve which one is which one. This was published 1 year later by Markov. So in 83, Famenkov in Moscow University offered to expand this approach by calculating so-called author invariant when he includes the 54 different functional words of language, and then calculate for every of them number per 1,000 word, sum of them, and say this is invariant which specific for given author. Idea is that when we put these words in the text, we can't precisely calculate its frequency. This is something personal, and it's very hard to mimic. This was idea behind. When it's tried to apply to wide number of authors, it was found that after number of candidate authors increased more than 20, the method failed. This discriminative power is relatively limited. Later was developed automated method based on the linguistic and grammar analysis, which tried to recognize the text in a more automated way, the same how text look like in linguistic sense. But all of them, the best of them, have accuracy. They can recognize about 30% of the authors, and this was on the case when the set was 783 authors on the data set. Then was very interesting work by Khmelev in 2001, which this is connected to the text with what was talked today about the linguistic transition between the letters. So what he did, he takes the every two sequential letters in the text, just in line, and calculate probability of transition from letter A to letter G, just how they follow in the text. The only thing, he removes the spaces from the text. He takes the text, removes the spaces, then he had the string of the letters, and then calculates this probability. And then he calculates the likelihood of author, which is in reality entropy term, and applies this and use this like estimation for the authorship of the text. He applies this for 385 texts for 82 Russian authors, and the accuracy was 73%. It's the highest which was at those time. And this is interesting because here the combination of the letter, one can think this is feature of the language. And then it's found it's not. It's enough to discriminate the people. So people use words according to which letters going one after another in the language. And this is interesting and funny. So something in our brain, how we think and how we behave. And this is quality what he achieved. Interestingly, that then, because this connected somehow how letters organized, this was another very interesting approach when people start to zip the text and like measure to discriminate authors. They try to find how much they can zip the text using the different standard zippers. They use the 7-zip, gzip, arch, rar, rarv, rarw. And it was found that this way is very good. With RRW, you can discriminate from the same set of authors. You can 73% of authors properly assign. Looking how the text is compressed. This is something connected with entropy in the text, because what in reality you do with all this compressor? They take the redundancy, which makes the maximum possible entropy of the compressed text. So the more its entropy is on the beginning, the less it will be compressed. So simple like that. And this is found was very good for separation, for selection. This is like introductory to things. And now I will go to experimental result when I try to use Bayesian network like classifier to classify the texts. So watch how experiment was done. So it was, I took the, from the public library of Mashkov, 75 Russian writers, and this was divided on two roughly equal set of books, 214 in one set, 243 in second set, which are mutually exclusive. No one book come to both set. So they was separate. And this divided by blocks by 1,000 word. So this was 10,000 in one set and 14,000 in another set. The number of letters is not so essential here. And for every block, frequency of each of 54 functional words, which was mentioned in the work of Fomenko, was calculated. Okay, this is wrong screenshot, but does not matter. So this is how it's roughly look like. So you have the word, you have the frequency of this, you have the frequency of this word, you have the standard deviation. And then what we did, I divided on the bins and to cover the whole field and make discretization of the data. After that, for every block, I have profile, which is 54 element vector, which discrete numbers. It could be from 0 to 3 or from 1 to 3 or from 1 to 7, depending on which bin they will come in. This I did to work with a discrete Bayesian network. So I discretize the data. So then I apply the naive Bayesian network, naive classifier, when the author is the only node which defines every 54 functional words. Very simple. Yep. And what I found that if I have, the first idea was if we do crude discretization, it could be bad because many authors come in the one bin. And then I can't discriminate them. In reality, it was opposite. If I divide on three bins, I have the highest recognition level, almost 85%. On the first level, 2 and 2 on the second, and 1.5 on the third in the probability if you correct one on position. Yeah? If I divide on five bins, it was 75, and seven bins, it was only 60%. So this first, my intuition that the discretization has to be fine enough was wrong, and crude discretization worked best in this particular case. Second, I decide to build the Bayesian network and find the structure of Bayesian network instead of naive classifier and try to find what I will get after that. As I told, I assume that prior for the structure is constant, but n prime could be different, and n prime I put one, and this structure which was reconstructed. Efficiently, it reduced it to 6 nodes only, and prediction power was miserable. It was only 20% prediction power. Then I start to try to move in one direction and decrease this value to 0.1. The situation was even worse. I have only 5 nodes in the network. I consider the nodes which really define the author. The rest is not connected to the author directly, and then it means its state does not influence the probability of the author. And prediction power 13%. So it's very close to be noise. If I move on another direction, and I move to the n equal 5, I have 17 nodes, and predictions start to be higher, 80%. With 10, 21 nodes, 83%. But when I go to 30, it starts to drop back. So in reality, result was in some sense disappointing, because the parameter which is supposed to be in the prior, some parameter of the prior n, is not non-essential, it is very essential. Depending how I choose it, I will get very different quality result. Because if I go here, I say, okay, here I have very good prediction, and I decrease number of nodes from 55 to 21, with very good space reduction, and very useful to apply it for the future study which I want to apply it. But I don't know how to choose this if I don't know the ground truth. Here I know ground truth behind, but in the other cases not. So, and this is like summary of all these things which is found, which I present here, that three-letter entropic is very good predictor, which is very weird, because this is not what I expect from the language and authorship. Then, very interesting that compression is very good predictor. It's again interesting from the point of view of literature and language. And from Bayesian network, naive network, use my knowledge of the structure. I know author define the probability of this, at least partially defined probability of these functional words. Although there are dependencies in the language dependent on the topic, etc. Topics are very different, this random taken from the library. And reconstruction of Bayesian network with n prime equal to 10 give comparable. If you take the variance, it's the standard deviation, they almost overlap quality of prediction. But I still don't know how in the case if I don't know the ground truth to find this. Of course, I can do it on the training set and hope that it will be applied for the real data. And this is what I'm going to do for functional genomic screen analysis. Thanks.